just there. It's quite straight. Okay. Yeah. This can make all the difference if you get it in the wrong place. The eyes looks too small. Even if you just get it a hair's breadth out, it doesn't work. But as I've said, you must have fun with this, really. You know, it's such a bind having to get it exact, but this is such a good picture. I just really want to capture that creature as near as I can. Okay, and then black in the center. Now, I can see from my pencil line that that is black there, but it's also thicker than the white, so it's coming out of there. This is slightly rounder, but it's not that round, so I'm going to go up a bit with that line. Slightly rounder. That's more elongated. It's a bit round in the corner there. Here it's not grey or black, but it's quite dark, so I'm just gonna carry that line on from there. And yeah, put it just on the outside of that, so it needs to go there, just above where I've marked it. That's a little bit square. And I'm going to go down there with this colour, very lightly. Yeah, so. See, the dark grey underneath the lighter colours will give it a nice sort of smoky effect, which would be good. Dark there. Just looking at this kind of distance from the bottom there. About right. And that needs to come off the corner there. That's it. Smidgen off there, and it doesn't really matter about that, but I'll take it off. Okay, that's it. When I get some pinky colours in there and fleshy colours, that'll be lovely. Leave that because it's quite pink there. And here, yeah, that's grey there. Okay, now I think what I'm going to do is do the colour of the eyes, do the irises now, and see how that looks. So there's a bit of darkness just here, I'm going to put that in, because if you don't put it in, it's very difficult to get it dark. A lot of shadow in there. And here, just along here, there's a dark mark there, and quite a dark mark here. It's quite dark here. Put some white in, make a bit of a good base. It's nice and clean. I think I might need to sharpen this. I'm not pressing hard now, just very light. A lot of colour in this cat's eyes, but not much in the way of highlights. This is quite a challenge really, because the highlights are what makes it come alive. Maybe put some in anyway. Got to be a bit careful about doing that though, you've got to be careful where you put them. Quite a nice little mark there. Keep that there, nice and a bit harder. And here, right up in the corner, that's why. Okay. It's not light in there at all. Okay. Mix the blue in with the dark black now. The black with the blue, it darkens it, but it's nice. And there, it's not black. The colour in there, and the line coming down there. Smudging blue over there. Okay. Right. Now, there's a bit of pink. I need some pink in there now. And it's kind of peachy. So I'm going to use this colour. Just do it. It's kind of yellowy and... no, that's wrong. That's it. That'll be better. Now, this goes over the back. Right, now I'm going to blend that in and see how that goes. Right, my blender. Very gently. Bring them back in there. Bring it back into the edge a bit. Right, let's go over this black. Okay, let's get some more colour in there now. Some darker blue. I think I'll do that blue as well. It's rather nice. dark patch here. Dark blue. Lots of shading here. That'd be a hard line there. So just leave that for the lighter colours. Just go over the dark, really dark colours now. Slightly over the blue. I think. Oops. Pink, and now we get that pink line over the grey, and then when we get it nice and smudgy,